This is the Eagle, 44,000 tons, the biggest ship in the Royal Navy, last of a lineage that would do credit to Debrett. There have been Eagles in the Navy since 1592. The 10th captured Gibraltar in 1704. The 20th escorted convoys to Malta in 1942. This is the 21st Eagle, built in 1951 at a cost of £15 million, refitted 10 years later for another £30 million. Earlier this year, she made a trip from Mombasa in Kenya, up the coast of Africa to Aden, and across the Indian Ocean to Singapore. This is a record of that voyage.
Where are you going?
We should be all right there.
Good job.
Get him forward.
The Eagle's teeth are her squadrons of Vixen and Buccaneer fighter bombers. The Buccaneers have nuclear capability. These planes land at between 120 and 135 miles an hour and are brought to a halt in 80 yards. Flying goes on almost round the clock, for without constant practice, the pilots soon lose touch.
Okay, stop him. Clear to land.
The captain, Captain John Roxburgh, DSO, DSC and Bar, was a wartime submarine commander.
Starboard 15.
What wheel have you got on? Starboard 30. Bring around quickly.
Starboard 30. East 5. 5 starboard on, sir. Steer 010.
Inside of B-boiler room.
B-boiler.
You increased your steam drum pressure desired value up to 420, please.
Although the ship has all the comforts of air conditioning, the temperature in the engine room in tropical waters often is as high as 120 degrees.
Bearing.
Let's get this down to the
threw away my last bomb. I wasn't going to waste any more.
Anyway, we're then plugged in. I made it all right. While you were just about to go in, they said change channel. Well, don't change channel when you're in. And that's why I came up and said stay on 8.
I couldn't see him back there. I still thought he was sitting low. I
no,
just couldn't tell where
he
was.
And, he didn't know where
then I started flashing it. Lunch.
No, the bloody thing's got to be, it has very sensitive throttle movement.
Lieutenant Commander Taylor, 665.
Last orders, please, sir.
Thank you, Bill.
Last orders, please, sir.
What are you trying to say?
The traditional rum ration is issued daily, neat for petty officers, two parts watered for ratings. A special ticket prevents the thirsty from coming back for more. Seamen of Nelson's day, with their diet of salt pork and maggoty biscuits, would have been aghast at what is served to their successors. Often the Eagle's crew have a choice of up to 10 dishes, including steak, lobster and trout.
Target, yeah. We went down there.
Stayed. We played them off pretty
well.
That's
good. Didn't look quite up to my.
Is there any beef inside?
Oh, I the last 6 weeks I've been on the, you know, the biggest water ship. And you live in a camp bed. So I'm quite liking this. Is great. You know, fantastic.
Port 10. 110.
We're in on the optional watch.
Request a correction, starboard. We've been easing round to port through a satisfactory course.
Mitchell?
110.
So 100.
We are sailing on 110.
Roger. On 110, sir?
Sorry, it's not error. We are coming back to 110 now.
Roger.
Hello, Secretary.
Hi, sir.
Morning, Sec. What have we got today?
Well, we've been invited to be affiliated with the Deep Sea Scouts.
Oh, my God.
Go ahead. This is the letter we had from them. Rather a lot of verbiage attached.
Well, now, surely we're adopted by some deep-sea
no,
girl guides.
The guides, yes, sir.
We can't have them using the same name, can they?
Well, there's no reason why they shouldn't.
Well, they scratch each other's eyes out.
We've drafted a reply, and we've mentioned the other organisations who have borrowed our name.
Uh-huh.
Apple
Yard. Ship it off to Apple Yard. To Psycho, please.
just want you to relax completely. Just relax. Good. Spit this out. That's it. Take a deep breath for me. Jolly good. All over. Well done. Let's enjoy the rest.
Good evening. The Eagle Broadcasting Corporation welcomes listeners to another edition of Mud in Your Ear. And this is Mud. We often have a problem trying to find the records that have been requested for from home. The average age of the ship's company of 2,700 men at 25, the pops are the most popular. The first request I have is beautifully printed in a large hand and comes from 62 Wollstone Avenue, Bromley Farm Estate, Fondleton, Cheshire, and says, Dear Mud, would you please play the following record for my boyfriend, Michael Barlow of Mess 4SO? It's Something Wonderful by Shirley Bassey. Please tell Michael that I love him very much, and I'm wishing the months away until August 66. Thanking you, Gene MacDonald, to you, Steward Michael Barlow.
Hands to flying stations.
Right, the exercise tonight is a glow strike upon the escort, which plane guard escort, which we will place astern. Once we've turned, four buccaneers to strike with glowworms and 2-inch RP. The strike will be opposed by a pair of low-set Vixens controlled by the Gannet. And in addition, we shall be launching again partway through your sortie. So in fact, the buccaneers will have to look slippy to get the full benefit from it, to get in, get their, all their attacks in.
Petty officers' messes, there are bars like this. Ratings are allowed 2 cans of beer a day. Petty officers, £3 worth a week. With beer at a shilling a can, this works out at about 9 cans per petty officer per day. In hot climates, many of them get through it all.